We all know the sacrifices made by firefighters, especially those who volunteer.
Easier to miss are the sacrifices made by the spouses of firefighters, a point recently brought home in a dramatic way. Boyd Hubert explains in tonight's Land of 10,000 Stories.
Leave it to a guy under a mask to steal the heart of this young lass.
I'm a lucky girl, that's for sure.
Krista Bursa now wears the ring of St. Paul Park firefighter, Jeremy Bursa.
He got down on one knee in the middle of the woods and popped the question.
11 years they dated.
Yep.
Yeah.
While Krista got her nursing degree, had a couple of kids, and adhered to their couple's credo.
If something happens, just roll with it.
Something like the last minute loss of their wedding venue.
I was definitely panicking, that's for sure.
So, roll with it.
Yeah, it was her idea.
Krista's idea.
What a cool spot, you know.
To move the wedding to the fire station.
She talked me into it.
I loved it.
December Orpin, their wedding photographer, fell in love with the creative possibilities.
This is a first.
Then found herself amused by the banter.
We kept joking, you know, what if there's a fire call? What are you going to do? You're not leaving our wedding, you know? No way.
She says jump, I say how high.
And that settled it.
Especially when it comes to that day.
Their firehouse wedding day was playing out perfectly.
My brother-in-law built a wall out of like old barn wood for us to have behind us. It was just so beautiful and so special.
And then, just after their wedding had reached its crescendo, this, not even 3 miles away.
I looked at her and she just kind of did the, no, we're doing pictures.
So on they posed, knowing after all the fire wasn't even in St. Paul Park, but Cottage Grove.
I had everybody lined up out front. We were doing our big group photo.
Then it got worse.
St. Paul Park Fire, request for mutual aid to Cottage Grove Fire.
They do what's called an all call.
Newport Fire all call.
Which is they need more people now.
I just looked over at Jeremy and I could just see it in his eyes. He felt so torn. And I just said, go ahead and go, babe. Just go. They need you. Go. Yep. It was a cool moment. It was a neat moment.
December kept shooting as the bridal party waved goodbye.
So you can see him in the truck in the back seat.
Just a handful of photos had been taken. The reception hadn't even begun.
Yeah.
And Jeremy was gone.
Yeah.
Taking leave from one of the best days of his life to help someone else on their worst.
Being, you know, the bride, that's your day. Words can't really describe it, you know.
But there was more to Jeremy's bride's selfless act.
It was extremely tragic. Yeah. Unbelievable.
2 years earlier, Krista's 9-year-old niece, Catherine, and 11-year-old nephew, Aaron, were staying with their aunt in Ohio when an overnight house fire killed them both. As the radio kept sounding.
Yeah.
That's where Krista's mind went.
I've got the rest of my life with him. You know, they needed him for that moment.
That just kind of put the icing on the cake for I know she's the one for the rest of my life.
Krista's grand march was on her father's arm. She led a prayer before dinner for the firefighters and the family losing its home.
Unconditional, unselfish love. Not only for each other, but for both of them, for their community. And for what's right.
3 hours later, the sun was setting when Jeremy finally made it back.
Yep.
December hastily snapped this photo.
You can just see the emotion in them. That's who they are.
Jeremy and Krista had rolled with it.
Yeah, it'll definitely be a day I won't forget.
Yeah.
And tempered their new bond by fire.
You just know that she is absolutely the one.
Boyd Hubert, KARE 11 News, St. Paul Park.
The Cottage Grove Fire Department tells us the cause of the fire Jeremy helped fight is still under investigation. The family living in that home did get out safely. There's now a GoFundMe page to help them, and you can find a link at KARE11.com.